Your OptiFiber Pro has something called auto OTDR mode. Well, what does that do exactly? Well, what that's going to do is it's going to make sure that the measurement you get is the very best possible measurement. There is also a manual OTDR mode. So in this video, I'm going to talk about the differences between auto and manual OTDR mode. Let's do that now by running an example. Oh, we'll run a test. Not going to save the last one. And this is in auto OTDR mode. So the OptiFiber Pro has selected the best range, the best pulse widths, and the most suitable averaging time to give me the most accurate result in the shortest time possible. And here we see 0.23 dB and a reflectance of roughly minus 40 dB. I can look at my trace, and when I zoom in, you'll notice that it's a little bit bumpy here. Now, there are some people who are going to go, well, that's a little bit too bumpy for me. I want to make that smoother. Well, the way that you would make it smoother is you would increase the test time. You would increase the number of averaging that's being done. To do that, we'll put it in manual OTDR mode. It's not going to change the outcome of the test result, but it will make for a prettier OTDR trace. So, home, edit, and we'll change it from auto OTDR to manual OTDR, where we have our manual OTDR settings. My averaging time is set to 40 seconds per wavelength. I can change that and put you through the misery of watching an OTDR measurement take 180 seconds per wavelength. That's a 6-minute test. You know, I'm not even too sure I want to wait 40 seconds, so I'm going to put it to 20 seconds. Let's do done. And save. And we'll use that one. Let's hit test. Don't want to save the last one. And now we'll run it in manual OTDR with that extra averaging time so we get a smoother trace. So instead of taking 12 seconds to do the test, it's now going to take 40 seconds. That's 20 seconds per wavelength. If you look very carefully, you could see it getting smoother there. And indeed, if we zoom in again, our trace now is a lot smoother. There's a couple little bumps in there, but again, if we added extra time to the test, we could even make this look prettier. But what about our event map? That's still showing 0.23 dB. And our reflectance is still around about minus 40. That's not exactly the same value as we had before, so we have a little change in reflectance there. But our overall result has not changed. So you can put it in manual OTDR mode if you wish, but there are dangers in doing that. Only do that if you've been on a proper training course for OTDRs and you understand the consequences of changing those settings. So that's auto OTDR versus manual OTDR. Don't forget to watch my video on test limits as well. That's a very important video to watch, as that will affect the outcome of your test results.